just 5 minutes discussion. Okay, so if still any errors are there, sir, if my SQL server is not starting, where I can see the errors, then you can use your event viewer. Okay, you can go to the event viewer. There you can select your MS SQL server. Okay, so there you can see. See here, we got this error, right? If you check .sha, log.sha and sales.sha, right? sales_log.sha, sales_sha. These are the data files, right? Data file and log file, right? Beginning of the class. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so no problem, Hema. Hema is still connected. Hema is there. Yeah, no problem, Hema. I'll just upload this video. Okay, see, if you are not getting the recording permissions, immediately you can ask me. Okay, immediately I'll give you the recording permissions. In case if I'm missing, just let me know again and again. Okay, so I can give you. Why? Because sometime while I'm in discussion, I might not see the messages and all. I may miss the messages. Okay, right. So fine. So in this way, see here, this is the error. Actually, this error belongs to SQL server, sales.sha and sales_log.sha. You can see, right? In this way, you can see all the errors in the event viewer. So based on that event viewer errors also, you can start troubleshooting. If your master is corrupted, you cannot start the SQL server. So if you cannot start the SQL server, where you can check the error log and all, it's not possible to check, right? So you can use this event viewer to check further. Okay. Is it clear, guys? Please. Any issues, any doubts? Clear, everyone? So resource database will play a crucial role. Okay. So you just now, we just checked that resource database data file and log file. Resource database data file and log file, nowhere you can see, only that is the way you can see the physical files, resource database data file and log file. And one more important point, if your resource database is also corrupted, you cannot start the SQL server. Okay. So that is also same like master database. Okay. So tomorrow's essay, is it clear, everyone? Any points you want to mention, anything you want to ask, any doubts, please? Sir? Yes. Yes. Tell me.
Repeat that point. If model is corrupted, we can't start.
I'll tell you. So if model is corrupted, see, for example, every time your tempdb is creating, right? Whenever you are restarting the SQL server, you are a new tempdb is creating. This is okay or not?
Yes,
is it clear? Clear, right? Very good. See, there is a property in SQL server. Whenever any new database is creating, it always depends on model database for different properties like initial size, path of the files. Okay, agree this one? That point is clear. This point is also clear, right? Whenever any new database is creating, it always depends on model database. Is this point clear, Kusma?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now merge both points. Merge both the points. Whenever you restart the SQL server, a new database is, a new tempdb is creating. Okay. Yes, and without model database, no tempdb or no new databases can be created. Okay, there are three important points. One is, whenever you restart the SQL server, a new tempdb is creating. Okay, first important point. Whenever you are restarting the SQL server, it will create a new tempdb. Okay, this is first valid point. Second point is, whenever any new database is creating, it will depends on model DB. Okay, is it clear? So whenever you restart the SQL server, if you mix both the points, whenever you restart the SQL server, a new tempdb is going to be created. So if the new tempdb is going to be created, first of all, model DB should be online, right? Then only tempdb can be created, right? And before to this, without tempdb, you cannot start the SQL server. This is also an important point. Third point, without tempdb, there is no SQL server. So if you mix all these three points, without tempdb, there is no SQL server. Means your SQL server won't start. Agree? Agree with this point? as without RAM, I cannot start my laptop, right? In the same way, without TempDB, I cannot start my SQL server. Kusma? Yes, then. Yes, okay. Without model database, you cannot create TempDB. Agree? Why? Because TempDB will be created freshly when you restart the SQL server. A fresh TempDB will be created when you restart. Right, whenever it is creating, your TempDB will look into the model database. If model is down, TempDB can't be created. If TempDB can't be created, SQL Server can't start.
Okay.
Agree. Don't compromise. Is it clear or not?
Sir, ante ippudu manamu TempDB lo before data anta untundi sir. If create chesinappudu, restart chesinappudu, TempDB data anta potundi.
Yes.
So
fresh TempDB will be created.
When we restart, TempDB won't be created.
Yes.
Okay. What about the data, sir?
Data will also be cleared. See, whatever. Remember one thing. See, TempDB itself is a temporary database. Okay. So it's not a permanent database. It's not a permanent storage to store the data permanently like other databases. So whenever you restart the SQL server, whatever data is there in the TempDB will be cleared automatically.
Okay, sir. So data potundi, SQL server start avadu. Ante data processing aagi potundi. Dani valla maniki SQL server start avadu.
Yes, that's it. If there is no TempDB, there is no processing. There is no data processing. There is no database to process the data. The main earlier while starting the classes, we discussed 3 points. SQL Server is a database software which helps to store the data, process the data, retrieve the data. Like, so if there is no process. If there is no processing is done, then how can SQL Server can start? So there is no SQL Server. In the same way, like if there is no RAM, you cannot start your laptop. If there is no TempDB, you cannot start your SQL Server. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, no, okay, I sir. Can hear a compromising voice from you. So are you clear or not? Still having issues, I'll tell you in Telugu. Em ledu, okay? So TempDB anedi eppudu kuda fresh ga create avutundi. ఓకేనా ఎప్పుడు కూడా ఎప్పుడైతే రీస్టార్ట్ చేసామో అప్పుడు ఫ్రెష్ గా TempDB క్రియేట్ అవుతుంది ఫస్ట్ థింగ్ సెకండ్ థింగ్ వితౌట్ TempDB
అది క్లియర్ అయింది సార్ నేను చెప్తాను జస్ట్ మనం ఎప్పుడైతే రీస్టార్ట్ చేస్తామో TempDB ఆల్రెడీ ఉన్న ఫైల్ డిలీట్ అయిపోయి న్యూ ఫైల్ క్రియేట్ అవుతుంది సో న్యూ క్రియేట్ అవ్వాలంటే మోడల్ DB ఆన్ లో ఉండాలి అది వర్క్ అయితే ఉంటేనే TempDB
ఆ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ని తీసుకొని ఆ ఇనిషియల్ సైజ్ ఆ పాత్ TempDB క్రియేట్ అవుతుంది కానీ అక్కడ ఇప్పుడు మనం కొత్త డేటాబేస్ క్రియేట్ చేస్తున్నప్పుడు మనం పాత్ అది ఇస్తాం ఎక్కడ క్రియేట్ అవ్వాలో ఏంటో ఆల్రెడీ డిఫాల్ట్ పాత్ ఉంటుంది మనం ఓకే కొట్టేస్తాం కానీ TempDB మాన్యువల్ గా ఆటోమేటిక్ గా క్రియేట్ అవుతుంది దాని పాతది ఎలా తెలుస్తుంది నేను ఈ పాత్ లో క్రియేట్ అవ్వాలని దానికి ఎలా తెలుస్తుంది మోడల్ డేటాబేస్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ నుంచి తీసుకునే కదా ఇది క్రియేట్ అవుతుంది మోడలే ఆన్ లో ఆఫ్ లో ఉంటే ఇది ఎలా క్రియేట్ అవ్వగలదు పాత్ ఎక్కడ క్రియేట్ అవ్వాలి ఎంత సైజ్ తీసుకోవాలో దానికి ఏం తెలుసు
అయితే ఇంకొక పాయింట్ సార్ ఇక్కడ ఈ TempDB లో మనకి మనం ఆల్రెడీ క్రియేట్ చేస్తాం కదా యూజర్ డేటాబేసెస్ అవి ఏమైనా ఇన్వాల్వ్ అయి ఉంటాయా సార్ వీటిలో
నో 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 ఇట్ వోంట్ ఇన్వాల్వ్ ఓకే సార్ మనం గుర్తుపెట్టుకోండి ఎప్పుడు మనం ఎక్కడ క్రియేట్ చేయట్లేదు ఒక న్యూ డేటాబేస్ క్రియేట్ చేసామంటే సార్ మాస్టర్ లో న్యూ డేటాబేస్ క్రియేట్ చేసాం కదా సార్ అంటారు మనం మాస్టర్ లో క్రియేట్ చేయట్లేదు TempDB లో క్రియేట్ చేయట్లేదు మనం SQL సర్వర్ లో క్రియేట్ చేస్తున్నాం న్యూ డేటాబేసెస్ ఓకేనా సో మాస్టర్ ఇక్కడ సెలెక్ట్ చేసి క్రియేట్ డేటాబేస్ డేటాబేస్ నేమ్ అని ఇచ్చి ఇది ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ చేస్తే ఇక్కడ మాస్టర్ ఉంది కదా నేను మాస్టర్ లో క్రియేట్ చేస్తాను చాలా మందికి ఇదే కాన్సెప్షన్ ఓకేనా సో ఇట్స్ నాట్ లైక్ దట్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ క్రియేటింగ్ డేటాబేసెస్ ఇన్ మాస్టర్ ఆర్ TempDB యు ఆర్ క్రియేటింగ్ డేటాబేసెస్ ఇన్ SQL సర్వర్ దట్స్ ఇట్ ఓకే స్టిల్ హావింగ్ ఎనీ ఇష్యూస్ ఎనీ డౌట్స్ గైస్ ప్లీజ్ ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ కుస్మ నౌ వై యువర్ SQL సర్వర్ వోంట్ స్టార్ట్ ఇఫ్ మోడల్ ఇస్ కరప్టెడ్
Okay, sir.
Not okay. Yes.
Sir, I have one doubt, sir.
Yes, yes, please.
Sir, what is the main difference between Windows authentication and SQL Server authentication?
I'll tell you in the security concept. Okay, there is a special class. I'll explain with the diagrams and all. How Windows authentication will work, how SQL authentication will work. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Any other question?
Sir, I have a doubt in Azure.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Tell me.
Sir, can 2 persons use in one VM? One person can use default instance, other person named instance in one SQL Server, in one VM.
Happily. Not only 2 persons, 32,000 persons can use the same VM. VM means SQL server. Okay.
So that but someone when one person connected, someone
that is different. That is closer. Different. See, that is different. That is VM RDP. Okay, you are asking about SQL server or VM? Only VM.
Actually, I connected through RDP.
Then your question is on SQL RDP server.
Yeah, I connected so, SQL server through RDP.
Okay, done.
So here default instance.
Okay.
Some my friend is connected through same RDP and the named instance. When he connected the named instance, I suddenly closed.
Which one?
Automatically.
Which suddenly closes? His connection or your connection?
My connection.
Why your connection will be closed suddenly? It won't. See, here forget about named instance or default instance, first of all. Okay. Forget about the named and default. Your RDP doesn't depends on named or default. Okay. Your RDP will completely depends upon your Windows machine settings. At a time, two persons can connect to your Windows machine. Okay. At a time, two persons can RDP to a single machine. If third person is connecting, then it will ask to disconnect, or the third person can kill that session, existing sessions and all.
Yes, sir. We tried, but I connected.
Might be in the Azure. You are using Azure VM?
Yes, sir.
Might be in the Azure VM, it will allow only one RDP at a time. I guess, yes, it will allow only one RDP at a time. Oracle VirtualBox VM will allow two RDPs. All Oracle machines. Okay, these machines will allow two RDP connections at a time parallelly. Azure VM will accept only one RDP session. If another person is taking your session, your session will be disconnected.
Yes, same thing is happening.
Yeah. Focus. Forget about default. That's not mistake of default or named. Okay, it's completely depends on your VM remote settings configurations. Might be you can increase that count, but that you have to check in the Google. You can increase that RDP count, remote desktop connection count, from 1 to 2. So you can increase that count. Just Google it and check and let me know, in case that will also helpful for me. Okay.
Okay.
Google it, how to increase the RDP connections. Google it and let me know the answer. Even I want to know the answer for that. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Thank you. Any other questions, any doubts?
Dinesh, sir.
Yeah, Dinesh.
Azure portal open chese oka IP address sir. IP address use cheskoni manam remote desktop ki connect aitam kada.
Yes, yes.
So IP address ippudu present nenu oka location lo unte inkoka location unde vallaku pampise
remote desktop open aitadu. Wait. I'm sorry guys. I'm sorry people are going to leave. Let me give you the assignment for tomorrow. Thank you, Muthu. So tomorrow assignment is, every database, every object will have one ID. Okay, table will have table ID, database objects will have IDs, file will have file IDs. Okay, databases will have database IDs. Now I want to know what are the database IDs for master, model, MSDB, TempDB, resource database. That is one assignment. Next assignment is, whenever you start the SQL server, which system database will come online first? I need a serial order. Okay, we have master, MSDB, TempDB, ModelDB, ResourceDB, right? In these five system database, which one will come to online first? First, which database will come to online? Next, which database will come to online? Like that, I need order. First, which database will, of course, you know, first master will come to online. You have already checked in the error log. I'll tell you where you can find the answer also. You can check in the error log. You can tell me the answer. Okay, first, which database will come to online? Next, second, which database? Third, which system database? Fourth, which system database? Fifth, which system database? Only system databases, not user databases. Okay, one is database IDs for all five system databases I need. Second one is, which system database will come to online? Okay, that also I need. Fayak, you can tell me the answer tomorrow. Okay, yes, you can continue the question, Dinesh. Sorry for that.
Yeah. IP address ఇప్పుడు అజర్ ఓపెన్ చేస్తే సార్ మీరు అజర్ ఓపెన్ చేసినారు సార్
yes yes
ఆ IP address యూస్ చేసుకొని నా ల్యాప్టాప్ లో రిమోట్ డెస్క్టాప్ ఓపెన్ చేసి ఆ IP address మీ నుంచి తీసుకొని
you can try see now you can try I'm just copy pasting you can try my session will be disconnected let me give you paste the IP address in the chat box you can try
oh, sir.
Happily you can happily connect from anywhere in the world. Even people are connecting from US also for the same server. You can try now also. Let me send to everyone. I just sent to Muthu only. Let me send to everyone. This is the IP address. Anyone can connect to this machine from MSTSC, from your desktop. My session will be disconnected. You can try it now.
Try
and let me know. Okay, 20.127.69.3. Let's see. Let's check, Kiran. I am not sure, but I guess he can connect. Let's check from Dinesh side. Dinesh, are you connecting? Are you trying?
I'm trying.
No problem, Pranit. You can go. Thank you for that.
Password?
Yeah, thank you, Shin.
Yeah, thank you, Pranit. Bye. Password?
Password.
Password, I won't give you, sir. It will cost. nothing like that. There is no secrecy in the password. Common password only I'll use. Okay, B41 admin is the username. Okay, and password is DBA classes 123. Okay, this is the password. Let me open this connection. Let me see whether you are going to take my connection or not. Let me know the outcome.
Connect in, sir.
In the?
In, sir.
See here, I got a message. You have been disconnected because another connection was made to the remote computer. If I click OK, my connection will be closed. Everything you will get. You got the whole screen? Why? Because you are using same credentials, right? You are not using your own credentials, right?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay, you are connected to B41 admin. The user is B41 admin, and I ran all the queries with the help of B41 admin. Don't do anything, sir. Okay. I have to do a lot of things with that machine. Okay, just I want to show you. Okay, you can connect from anywhere. You can connect from anywhere in the world.
Sir, can you please go to that Azure portal network security group, sir?
Network security groups. Okay, let me go to the networking. And a network security group.
Okay, 1 second, sir. Inbound rules only, sir. I need to check inbound rules.
Okay. You want to check inbound rules only? Okay.
Yeah. Then. Basically, he will not be able to connect. I think allowed for any, sir. That is why he is able to connect.
Yes. Yeah. It should be any. Allow. Okay. It should be any. Okay,
yeah, inbound basically
rules, outbound rules any. Okay, that's why you can connect. Allow is there. Usually in the organization, it will be disabled because of security.
Yes.
Okay, so yes. No one can connect in the organization like that. If that is the case, everyone can connect to organization servers, right? So it will be disabled by default. You have to enable it. Yeah. Yes, you are correct.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Guys, any questions, any doubts? No doubts, no questions. Good. Is it clear, everyone? So tomorrow's assignment is clear, right? So tomorrow. Wow. Okay, tomorrow's assignment is you have to complete those two tasks, and tomorrow will sharply start at 7 o'clock, guys. That's it. In case of any questions, you can ping me in the WhatsApp. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you all. Bye.